Dear students, let's start with the topic of transistor. Transistor is a semiconductor device, and about it we can write that it is a two-junction semiconductor device, and it is made in two ways. There are two ways in which a transistor can be developed or manufactured. As we have written that it is a two-junction semiconductor device. One way is by taking a P-type semiconductor and we sandwich it between two N-type semiconductors from the two sides. This becomes NPN transistor. And obviously, as there are three semiconductors making two junctions, there are three terminals of a transistor. And this is termed as NPN transistor. And obviously, the other way in which it can be made is called a PNP transistor, in which an N-type semiconductor is sandwiched between two P-type semiconductors from two of the sides. So, this will be PNP transistor. And again, there are three terminals of the transistor. And we can also write that the three terminals of a transistor are called emitter, base and collector. In general, on paper representation, the middle semiconductor, which is sandwiched between the two similar kind of semiconductors on the two sides, is called base. On the left side, it is denoted as emitter. On the right side, it is collector. These are also written by the symbols B, E and C. About the basic characteristics of base, emitter and collector, let's continue on the next sheet. If we just discuss about the emitter terminal of a transistor, about this we can write, it is one of the side sections of the transistor, and it is heavily doped. Heavily doped means the concentration of impurity is very high. So, obviously, the majority charge carriers in the emitter are numerous in quantity. And we can also write it as heavily doped relative to other section. That means we are talking about base and collector. So, emitter is having maximum number of majority charge carriers. And that is heavily doped, and we can also say in a circuit, emitter emits majority carriers to the other sections, other parts of transistor. Basically, we can say in case of NPN transistor, if emitter is N-type, it emits electrons to the base and collector, and if it is a PNP transistor and emitter is of P-type, then emitter emits several number of holes to base and collector. Now, other than emitter, we just talk about base. We already seen that it is the middle section of transistor, and we can say it is very thin when it is constructed. A transistor is constructed, base is kept to be very thin and very lightly doped. You must understand, if we are given with a transistor and the middle section is very thin, which we are calling as base, and on left side it is emitter, on right side it is collector, Here we can say if it is NPN transistor, there are plenty of electrons there in the emitter because it is N-type. And if it emits a lot of electrons toward the base, as base is very thin and very lightly doped, being a P-type semiconductor, if there are very few holes can combine with very few electrons which are emitted from the emitter. So, majority of electrons will pass through base toward the side of collector. That's why this section on the other side of base is called collector, because it collects majority of carriers which are emitted from emitter. And base is not able to absorb most of these charge carriers because it is very lightly doped and very less number of majority carriers are available. So, similarly, we can write about collector, which we have just now discussed. For collector, we can say, in a collector, we can write, it is the side section on other side of base, and majority carriers emitted by emitter are collected by collector. The reason we already discussed that base is lightly doped, very few majority carriers are present here. So, most of the carriers which are emitted by emitter will pass through the base toward the collector. And always remember, there are few important facts about a transistor, like and the most important thing I'm writing here, which we are going to discuss in detail in coming sections of the topic, that is, in normal operations of a transistor, its base emitter junction is forward biased and its base collector junction is reverse biased. This is a general condition under which a transistor is operated in different circuits. And from the next section, we'll discuss about different phenomena and applications related to transistor.